See, that's quite obviously overloaded. Curved edge on that blade, just a little curve and then just a bit rounded off there. So you do most of your scraping with that edge. You just use that to get digging these corners a little. I'm about to cut a couple of pieces off. There was a piece going across there to there, which looked a bit ugly. And there was a piece going across there as well. I'll show you that. Just leave it all on, it's sort of a bit polished. I was distracting from the flow of it, so I've cut it off. So, let's just get whittling here. Now we're getting near the end of it now, so you can see now it's starting to dry up. Still okay. Another few days, it's really difficult. Don't take anything too big on at first, you know, kind of something like this, something smaller. It's a bit easier to come out, isn't it? So try something small. Sitting there thinking, why don't you sandblast it? Well, no. All that will do is just rip the wood away, all of the wood. Doesn't know the difference between the bark and the wood underneath sandblasting. It's not like doing metal. And the other one is, why not dry it, soak it, and then jet wash it? Well, you can jet wash it, but you can't jet wash green stuff. It has to be old, and then you soak it in water for, or leave it out in the weather for a week, and then you can hose it, jet wash it, and get quite a lot of it off. But you still have to do all this business. You still have to get in there and pack away. Anyway, it was easy to be all over the place these, wouldn't they? Don't see many of them around, do you? Small decorative things with vases of flowers and stuff, about the most. I've seen some pretty nice one-offs in the time there. Chairs and tables. I've seen these sculpts as well, that's kind of what I tend to go for. I want to see what it's saying to me. Fascinated by how it always says something different to other people. Stand it up and still. Three bloody heavy.
Let's stand it up. Back it up a bit. Wash it up. Knock all the loose stuff out. You can see that's pretty interesting, eh? Pretty interesting. So let's turn it over. Do this a bit. Dirt myself. Get it bang the other way up. Look out. So, little round mallet here. So, mate of mine, Dave. Just knocked up on his pole lathe in the wood the other day. Knock some of these off. Direction the wood's going. Then we're going to try and get the log out of the middle. Kind of looks interesting with it on the log. But I can assure you it will look a lot more interesting when the log's not in there, because you can see through it. So I'm just thinking about that now. Awful lot of work. Every time we get across like that, there'll be a little reach in the wood. And what I have to do is hack through with a chisel. I'm going to demonstrate that. I've got to work myself through, break the wood, cut it in two halves. Couple of cups of tea, chipped away now, almost halfway through the log.
just look up the thing, I can see up the bloody thing. There we go. So I'm almost halfway through the log, so next time you see it, I'll have got that last bit out. Oh, all going away. Some chippings, chippings. See you later.
Okay, so I've chiseled away. And most of it out, giving it a bash at the back here. And just set the pieces down loose. Here she goes. So then all I've got to do is weed it out.
Bark out the middle now. Later.
Start taking some of the bark off the inside. So just show you how I do that. Obviously, can't get it with a knife. I can a little bit, but so I get the back of the back side of the chisel. And just sort of forcing. Hopefully, you can see this. Just carefully. Under the bark. For the moment, so just going to phone out,
walk around here, and have a look at the inside. There you see, you can see, starting to see some perspective now as it lightens up. You see, okay, yeah. Holes just appeared there with the working neck, and you can see that. And so that's good. So what you've done is cleared that, and now dust will drop through the thing instead of building up from the crevices. It's easy to clean. It just gets messy, and the dust gets in there, and the spiders start living there. So that's the practical reason we do it. And the artistic reason is if we move down here, there you see where I've cleaned a lot bit out, and how the whole thing is starting to look very tactile now. There'll be another work with fine sandpaper on that, and then it's quite good for blind people, really. Very tactile art. Smooth, so that's what you want. You want to run your hands down there. There should be no snags. Everything should be smooth. And if that's the same, if that's the way with your hand, then it'll be the way with your eye. Let's just step back a little bit. See, it's getting quite nice now. Let me turn it a little bit. Let's have a look at the other vista. Let's have a view there. There you see. Remember earlier we had two things here. I've cut them off in the event.
He strikes you as oddly potent, and I'm almost nervous to pick it up.
Right, we're going to go take the rough edges off now, using rasp. Yeah, these old-fashioned tools. You can still get them, obviously. Just a rough file designed for rasping wood. You can knock all these sharp edges off like that. So I'm just going to go along here. And I'll speed it up so you're not waiting all day.
Right, now we'll take a few bits more off of this, and for me that's just starting to take a bit of shape now. Some interesting figures developing in there. Touch of alien there, I think, isn't there, at the top there. Let's walk on around. Ooh, there we go. That's it. We've got a bit more form in it now. There you see where I've left a stump in the bottom. So that's good. Okay. So, a bit more rubbing down and smoothing. And the smoother it gets, the more it flows. And the more attractive it gets, the more you see, especially around there. I've got that rounded off, shaped a bit more. They look really cool.
Saying soft back paper is usually used for metal, but actually I find it's quite useful for this, and I kind of prefer on the finish to use a worn piece. I'll use a bit with this first and I'll go over it with a smooth stuff. So basically we'll go all the way along here. First of all, what I'm going to do is put this here.
Thank you.
Okay, right. I put this out in the garden. Took advantage of the crappy weather. Went down the garden to season out for a few days. I've just had a scrape inside. All those bits in there of a scraper. And what I'm going to do now is take a hose pipe to it and get inside with a hose pipe all these cracks in here, blast it out. And then I'm going to have to let it stand for probably 3 or 4 weeks, maybe 3 weeks, depends on the weather really, on the humidity. And then it gets its first coat of oil. So, there you go. So, see you later.